Foraminifera are single-celled protists that range in size from that of a grain of sand to a few millimeters long. Foraminifera make shells of calcium carbonate, or build their shells from sedimentary grains in their environment. These shells readily preserve in marine sediments, and we can find these microfossils from 570 million years ago to the present day. This makes them a wonderful tool for reconstructing ancient environments. Because different species of Foraminifera lived at different times over their 540 million year history, identifying the Foraminifera that are preserved in a sediment sample allows micropaleontologists to determine the geological age of the sediments. This process is called biostratigraphy and is important for relating distant bodies of marine rock to each other as we piece together the Earth's geologic history and for tracing economically important petroleum source rocks. Different species of Foraminifera also prefer different environments. Thus, the species we find in a sediment sample gives paleontologists the ability to reconstruct changes in oceanic conditions through time. Foraminifera can be either planktonic or benthic. Planktonic Foraminifera live suspended in the water column and are especially sensitive to changes in ocean temperatures. These Foraminifera are instrumental in recording glacial-interglacial climate changes over hundreds of thousands of years. Benthic Foraminifera live on the seafloor or within the seafloor sediments. The fossils of benthic Foraminifera are very common in the sediments of shallow ocean depths. In addition, different species of benthic Foraminifera live on the continental shelf, the continental slope, and on the abyssal plain. Knowing which species occur at which water depths in the modern sediments allows paleontologists to use the remains of Foraminifera to determine past changes in sea level along coasts. With this data, they can predict how sea levels will change in the future. Different types of Foraminifera also respond to changes in food and oxygen availability at the seafloor. By examining the changes in Foraminifera in ancient sediments, we can reconstruct how oxygen and food availability changed with ancient climate changes and understand how modern climate change will affect ocean ecosystems. This video will focus on the morphological characteristics of benthic Foraminifera that micropaleontologists use to differentiate among different species and reconstruct ancient environments. Among benthic Foraminifera, the first characteristic important for identifying major species groups is the material from which the Foraminifera makes its shell. Agglutinated Foraminifera embed sediment grains and the remains of other organisms into an organic matrix to make their shells. Both hyaline and porcellaneous Foraminifera use carbonate to make their shells, but porcellaneous Foraminifera have a smooth, opaque shell, whereas hyaline Foraminifera are dotted with pores and often translucent. Just identifying these different shell types can help reconstruct the salinity of ancient bays and estuaries. Procellaneous Foraminifera are most abundant in hypersaline environments, while agglutinated Foraminifera dominate brackish water environments, and hyaline Foraminifera are most common in normal marine conditions. The shapes of the overall Foraminifera are very diverse, and is the second thing you should observe when trying to identify a species. Foraminifera may have a shape like a vase, or a cone, or an arrowhead, or a lens, an oval, a disc, or a fan, among many other potential shapes. As you examine the overall shape, you may need to look at the Foraminifera from a few angles to understand its shape in three dimensions. To help you visualize the Foraminifera in three dimensions, the images you will see will show three views of each specimen. In the form shown here, you see its umbilical side, an edge view with the aperture facing outward, and its spiral side. Most Foraminifera grow by adding chambers to their shell to accommodate the growing cellular material that makes up the organism itself. Sometimes the chambers are shaped like short and broad boxes, and other times they are long and thin, with the long axis of the chamber parallel with the long axis of the overall Foraminifera. The chambers may also be inflated and globose, with rounded chamber walls shaped like arches, or have walls that meet at sharp angles. Some Foraminifera have only one chamber, while others may have dozens of visible chambers. The first initial chamber, or proloculus, of a Foraminifera is nearly spherical in shape, and chambers are added as the Foraminifera grows. The pattern by which chambers are added determines the overall shape of Foraminifera's shell and varies across genera. This is one of the most important morphological characteristics to recognize when trying to identify a Foraminifera. Unilocular Foraminifera have only one chamber, Others add chambers in a single row or column and are called uniserial. Biserial foraminifera have two rows of chambers added on either side of a central axis. Triserial foraminifera have three rows of chambers, which sometimes appear to twist around each other as the chambers get larger over time. Some foraminifera coil in two dimensions, creating an expanding spiral outward from the initial chamber. These are called planispiral. If the coiling is offset in a third dimension, coiling outward and upward at the same time, this creates a cone shape and is called a trochospiral chamber arrangement. Some foraminifera even combine these arrangements, transitioning from triserial to biserial over the lifespan of an individual, or adding chambers along two rows, like a biserial, while also coiling. These different morphologies reflect the different lifestyles of the foraminifera and are related to the environments in which they live. For example, biserial and triserial foraminifera often live deeper within the sediment than other forms and are more tolerant of low oxygen conditions. The aperture is another important characteristic for identifying foraminiferal species. This opening is what allows the cellular material inside to communicate with the outside environment to gather food. It is associated with the youngest chamber of the foraminifer. The shape of the aperture varies among genera from round to an elongate loop to a thin slit. Some genera have apertures made of multiple pores or many slits radiating outward from a central point. The aperture may be located at the end of the youngest chamber, on the face of the youngest chamber, or tucked along the chamber margin. As I'm sure you've noticed, foraminifera have a great deal of morphological variation, especially given they are single-celled organisms. As you learn to notice and identify these different shapes and forms, you may also notice differences in ornamentation that can help you identify different genera and species. Sometimes the aperture will be set on the end of the neck that extends out from the chamber wall, or if you look down in the aperture, you will see small projections or teeth. Or you may notice ridges and bumps on the chamber walls that help you to recognize the genus or species. Keep an eye out for those details as you explore the morphology of foraminifera and use their morphology to decode ancient environments.